trip on our way to Cincinnati. We're learning Hebrews 10:39. We're memorizing it. So, Hebrews 10:39.
Is there a cheat card so that you don't think that we're cheating?
But we are not of those. You gotta say it with me.
No, no, you gotta say it on your own.
Okay.
Well, this verse, it's corporate, so it says, but we. Mm-hmm. So I'll say it with you, just because it's in context. You see it?
Thanks.
Right.
Hebrews 10:39. But we are not of those who shrink back and are destroyed, but of those who have faith and preserve their souls. Hebrews 10:39.
See how it didn't cheat? There's only one set of cards. However, on the phone that you just got pictures from, this is my phone. And I've got an app. Let's see here. That's you looking back at you.
We got an Elantra, and it's red. It's brand new. It has so many more cool things than the Versa does. And it's very quiet. Not a lot of road noise. We got a brand new GPS. It's only 2 months old. That actually has a compass on it. And look at the beautiful day for our drive to start out on.
Isn't that nice?
Pretty nice, huh? Hey.
Space. Therefore, he calls such persons a generation of his wrath. Isaiah 10:6. God will send them to hell to do penance for their hypocrisy. Number two, to make only a show of godliness is self-delusion. Ajax, in his frenzy, took sheep from men, but it is a worse mistake to take a show of grace for grace. This is to cheat yourself, deceiving your own souls. James 1:22.
Well, good morning. This is the second day of our grand escapade to Prince Edward Island. We have now driven through the night. Lauren took over at about 2 o'clock in the morning. And as you can see, we are approaching Boston with the foggy weather, and otherwise we've been reading and memorizing a little bit of scripture, and it's Sunday, so we might just have to listen to a sermon, and we've been eating chocolate and trail mix, and oh yeah, Starbucks, a little bit of that, nothing too exciting, so we'll see you in a bit. Well, we're here in Concord, Massachusetts, the home of Little Women, Louisa May Alcott's very own house. So this is pretty exciting. It's closed right now because it's Sunday. And here is our car, our faithful Hyundai Elantra. And there's Lauren taking a picture of me. Here we are at Harvard's campus. In one of the quads that is in front of their huge library. Say hi, Lauren. And this guy in the background is giving a tour to these people. We are here at Clover Foods. Yeah. And he's having an eggplant.
Egg and eggplant sandwich.
It's pretty amazing.
This is the smartest concept
ever. Yeah, if you take a look, here we got some vines working their way up here. Everything's green in here and edgy. Here are the seats. And you can see the walls. People color, put stuff on the walls. They got little places over there to sit. Work on a Hebrew poster.
So here we are in Portland, Maine. Oh, Jay's
Oyster.
And this is our delicious seafood extravaganza.
Sure. Let's bring that.
Say hi to our lobster.
Hey.
And having clams. Yep, Lauren's really going at it. Looking a little clammy. I'm feeling a little clammy. And we're going to see you later. Here we are. The streets of Portland.
Video?
Yeah. Just getting a nice little pan of it. This is it, folks. We're here approaching the bridge to PEI. Have a look around. It's pretty awesome. It's 10:42 Monday morning, and Lauren just woke up. Over and out. Okay, here's the school bus that Grant drives. Here's the lovely home, and we're gonna go inside and see what it's like. Lovely flowers out here. It's a little drizzly today, but here's the living room and lovely old piano and little figurines across the top. Some close-ups of those and little figurines across the piano top. And more over here, and beautiful little kitchen. Look at those cabinets, cupboards, the family. Family pictures, table, outside view, and the china. And right here we have an upstairs, and a downstairs. We go downstairs. Here is the den. Little TV room, little old heating stove, laundry room, computer station, graduation photos, more figurines, car models, motorcycle, and here is a bookshelf, and it goes into my room, which was Troy's room. And it's a lovely little room. The best part about it is Charles Spurgeon lectures to my students. We go back out here, up the stairs. You see master bedroom, little bathroom, and this is Lauren's room. He's sleeping. He's really tired from the trip. Yeah. So, thanks for joining me. This is the Thomas House, and it's lovely.
Mm-hmm. Very nice. Have a good day.
You too. driving on PEI towards Cavendish. I want to see these roads. This is such a pleasant drive. It's incredible views.
See out here. Delicious terrain. The grass is green, the fields are plowed. There's even a farmer over there plowing his field. Anyway, and we have impatient drivers behind us, which is awesome. Get yourself.
Get that. His license plate says tater.
I'm gonna go and catch that tater. I love it. Anyway. It really is magical, like the air is magical. I woke up this morning before the sun came up, so I beat the sun. Can't get over it. We haven't done our memory verse yet for the day, but we have... You read your Bible, didn't you?
A little bit.
Yeah, I read mine. I read the Psalms of the day. Psalm 27 has got that verse in it, that faithful are the wounds of a friend, better than the kisses of an enemy. And this guy, faithful friend. So,
here we are on Brackley Beach, Prince Edward Island National Park, and here's the gorgeous water. There's Lauren going out to see how cold it is. It's very, very cold. I already checked it out. I don't think I'll be swimming here, but maybe we'll do some swimming in Surrey later today. Hopefully it'll get warmer by then. Well, hello, here we are on the North Coast Drive. Unbelievable scenery. We just were at the beach for about 2 hours. And there's Lauren driving. You can see we got dunes on this side and then ocean beyond them. And then we have ocean over here. Perfect blue skies. Oh, I wish you could be here. Alright, so we've come out to this abandoned dirt road port. And there is no one out here. It is gorgeous. And here's Lauren. I'll just show you his head because he's got a shirt on. And I've got my shirt off.
Because it was proudly, authentic.
Proudly keeping the record of the whitest person here.
Yeah, he wins.
And we're...
We need to go.
We're thrilled. We got to go.
Oh, crap.
Here is the eastern point, or the east point, the easternmost point of the island. We're looking across the Atlantic Ocean. If you look really closely, you can see Europe. And there's Lauren. And there I am. And there's a lighthouse in the background. Isn't that cool? Yeah, a little tourist thing.
Good morning. It's Lauren and Quinny / Andrew. We are here to, well, one, review this lovely scenery outside.
Oh, yeah.
Look at that.
We just passed the Blue Goose restaurant.
Oh yeah, we passed the Blue Goose restaurant.
We thought of you.
Yeah. Oh, by the way, side note, did you know that my dad calls my mom Goose? Anyway, thought that was funny too. Yes, it is memory verse time.
Okay. Ready?
Upside down.
James 4:16-17. As it is, you boast in your arrogance.
All such boasting is evil.
So whoever knows the right thing to do and fails to do it, for him it is sin.
Nah, I messed up.
And then we were recently, we were just discussing the difference between sin and evil, actually, okay?
So, sin is a specific kind of moral evil
against a person.
Against a person.
And
don't forget about the persons in the Trinity that counts.
Evil is a broader range of meaning, especially in Hebrew.
Ra. Yeah, Ra.
Yeah.
Ra. Like in Isaiah. Don't worry, we'll find it. It's evil, calamity, and destruction. And it says God creates, I think it's Isaiah 46:10, but we'll check back with you. And
anyway, we're going to Charlottetown, and we're going to go from there to Montague in the southeastern coastal drive. And Montague is called Montague the Beautiful, so it should be stunning.
It kind of sounds like, Montague kind of sounds to me like a warthog. If I was going to name a warthog, it would be Montague. I mean, it'd be a regal name, but it's still a warthog.
Show her some of the scenery, dude.
Okay. Wait, so you can't zoom in?
No, you can't zoom while it's rolling. But
rolling.
Rolling.
Action. Churchill.
So
like
anyway.
Winston.
We're excited. It's another beautiful day. It got a little cloudy just now, but man, you should have seen the fields earlier,
under
just a minute ago.
Sky.
Oh my goodness. So.
Oh, P.S. Just so you know, I got up and watched the sunrise this morning. I went into our beloved friend's room and asked him if he wanted to watch the sunrise, and he goes. It's like this. You take pictures for me. It was the most glorious sunrise ever. It had nice, lovely, deep shades of purple, pink, lavender, orange, and then the black sky was over and behind me. And as it's happening, it's like you're looking to this. Just right over the edge of the horizon. Just beautiful. Anyway, so this got to be 3 minutes.
Yeah, we better go.
Bye.
Bye.
Okay, so it's really zoomed in, but I wanted you to see this long way spot right here. No, no, you don't want to do that. You don't want to do that. You're really close. Okay. So we're gonna. Yeah. We're gonna do it.
Okay. Hey, where's your card? You gotta show her.
I'm gonna show her my card. Okay, so here's the vista that we're looking at. These are the lovely flowers that we see. He calls them dragon
fireweed. Hey, get up closer.
You have no idea. You have no idea how far zoomed in at. That's why your face was funny. Anyways, can you see that bird? There's a bird. Anyway, so we're gonna pause this one. I just want you to see the vista. And there's the ocean sneaking around through there. Okay. So I gotta hurry up. So we're gonna pause this, fix the zoom, and then we'll record again.
Here's the zoomed out view. Here I am, and here's Lauren.
Hi.
And here's this fancy journal, and he was just working on a special card. Made by it's art.
Yeah, it's art by
a gay guy.
It's made by a gay artist named Tony Diodati.
Yeah. It's pretty decent. And
it's pretty good art. Check it out.
He wrote a lot on it. Here, show her.
I'm going to show you.
Look at that. A lot of writing for his
girl.
I
made some mistakes.
Yeah.
Oh, but my favorite sentence thing is,
This here blue eyes and wildflower skin.
Aww.
Hi, Kay. It's Lauren and...
Andrew.
Yes, I am shoved up through the sunroof, and that is definitely the ocean ahead of us, and we're driving on this goofy road to get to, and that's where we came from. We're so headed this way.
Hey, Brad, how are you doing?
Hey, Brad, welcome to the party.
Incredible field we're passed on the way to Montague. Love the texture of green here.
I don't think you'll be able to hear him, but he is about 30 feet in front of me. He's waiting on me to take a picture. He has another green Eskimo whenever he added some of it.
Hey!
I was supposed to take like some sort of artsy photograph of it or something.
What? Alright, hang on real quick. Turn back around. I was trying to get the stuff right.
Our little secret. Anyways, bye, Kay.
Good morning, we're at this lighthouse overlooking the Summerside Bay. We're actually on the top of the lighthouse. Here's Lauren, say hi.
Thanks for talking to me.
And yeah, here's the top of the lighthouse. Here I am. And here's the boat lineup. And it's a nice little panoramic view you get. Just a little area, a little wharf shop. And such.
Form, but who had turned out on further acquaintance to be rational and friendly. Under an alien exterior, he had discovered a heart like his own. Was he now to have the reverse experience? For now he realized that the word human refers to something more than the bodily form or even to the rational mind. It refers to that community of blood and experience which unites all men and women on Earth. But this creature was not of his race. No windings, however intricate, of any genealogical tree could ever establish a connection between himself and her. In that sense, not one drop in her veins was human. The universe had produced her species and his quite independently. All this passed through his mind very quickly and was speedily interrupted by his consciousness as the light was changing. At first he thought that the green creature had, of herself, begun to turn bluish and to shine with a strange electric radiance. Then he noticed that the whole landscape was a furnace of the short-lived evening was kindled all about him. In a few minutes it would be pitch black, and the islands were drifting apart. Speaking slowly in that ancient language, he cried out to her, "I am a stranger. I come in peace. Is it your will that I swim over to your land?" The green lady looked at him with an expression of curiosity. "What is peace?" she asked. Ransom could have danced with impatience. Already it was this...
Yeah, those are pretty darn big. Are you videoing?
Look at all those seagulls out there.
Wow.
Alright, here we are, the North Cape of Prince Edward Island, the northernmost western tip of the island. Look at that beautiful lighthouse.
Isn't that magnificent? And look at the contrast of the water, from the shore to the brown, to the green, to the deeper green, to the green. and then the never-ending blue. And God knows it all.
And we're at the edge of a cliff, and very much like, see these cliffs? This is, must have been what Dean rescued Emily from, that you were kind of looking for.
See that?
Down here, you can kind of see these black little specks. These are big jellyfish,
yeah,
actually.
They're evil.
They're everywhere.
I'll tell you what they really, swear word.
Two bad words.
Two bad words.
And we're going to, there's a little embankment down yonder that we're going to go down to and wash Lauren's jeans in the ocean.
Yep. I might just wear them too.
And so,
it's gonna
welcome to the North Cape. Oh, and we just got, here, we got it, stand up. We just got certificates for from tip to tip. So the East Point and the West Point. We got, they did calligraphy and everything and gave us these little certificates in the store
yeah.
there. So
we're going to put it on the
fridge
when we get home.
Yeah, and blue ribbons.
Blue ribbons. Second ocean I've ever been in. Dude, this is amazing.
Well, the sun came out and I cannot get enough of this sparkling water. Look at this. We are here completely alone. No one in the world around on this isolated beach. There's Lauren again. We came down this little entrance slope. Simply not gonna believe your eyes at this. We're here at a steak and seafood restaurant, but as you can see, there's a rainbow right out. This is the view from the restaurant. It's about 5:30. Got a lighthouse in the distance.